As you've guessed, I'm continental. Romantic and sentimental. I look on love as something of an art. But I found that nationalities have different formalities when dealing with affairs of the heart. Now, a Spaniard need a soft guitar and a balcony to climb, while the Portuguese need the breeze in the trees, but an Englishman needs time. The Italians long for an operatic song or a soft Sicilian rhyme, while the French fall in love at the drop of a glove, but an Englishman needs time. He'll admit your attraction, but show no reaction. His lips never part in a sigh. What goes on in his breast is completely suppressed by the weight of his old school tie. The Viennese need a waltz by Strauss or a glockenspiel's a sweet chime, while the Dutch begin with a bottle of gin, but an Englishman needs time. A New Yorker's need is variety and speed, but out west they're more sublime. At a Hollywood ball, they'd need nothing at all, but an Englishman needs time. He will meet you, maybe Monday night, but unless he's quite unique, he will call you up around Wednesday noon. You get flowers Thursday week. Though you'll have to wait, he may work up to a date, but if he's real mad for you, he will tenderly say, you look smashing today, and invites you to the zoo. When you think it's all over, this mad Casanova arrives in a purposeful way. But if he mentions sport, no, it's not what you thought, it's to watch him play cricket all day. Now in Persia, they need seven veils for a sultan in his prime, while an Eskimo need a whole lot of snow, but an Englishman needs time. Now I love all you Swedes, but you must admit you are terribly Swedish. But after all is said and done, and the battle is finally won, ladies, let's contemplate. Who wouldn't wait for a mate who takes his time?